Lindsay here, the Frugal Crafter. Today I'm going to show you how to make a cute little bow out of a scrap of wrapping paper because you're probably knee-deep in wrapping presents right now. If you're anything like me anyway, I kind of put things off to the last minute. Well, actually, no, I wrap as I go, but I always seem to have some stuff at the last minute to do. So what you want to do is grab one of those, wrapping paper scraps. This is about 12 inches long, and it's that gorgeous double-sided stuff that it almost kills you to use because it's so pretty and you can't decide which side. So it's, you know, my own personal holiday problem. First world holiday problems, right? So you want to take that strip of leftover wrapping paper and you want to fold it in half. And then what you're going to do is you are going to start here at the middle, right on the fold. You're going to cut like a bump up and you're going to cut a bump down. Then you're going to cut kind of like an arc all the way to the end of your strip. All right. Then you're going to turn it and you're going to do this. You're going to mirror that. Okay, go in where it's going in. Go. It's gonna look like a fish, kind of. Well, mine wasn't too symmetrical, but you get the gist. Okay, so this is what it looks like flat. You can also notch the ends if you want, because these will be the ends of our bow. I wouldn't take too much off here because you don't want to miss too much. You don't want to lose too much. Now, on these two indent parts, what you want to do is cut a slit halfway through on one side of one end. Then on the other side, you're going to cut the slit on the opposite. So this is on the bottom. This one's going to be on the top over here. Okay, so we've got those slits. Now I want the candy cane stripe kind of showing, so I'm turning it around. So the candy, it looks like a pair of glasses. So it goes from looking like a fish to a pair of glasses. Now you're going to kind of roll into a circle and you're going to put the two slits together. So they interlock like that. And then you're going to pinch it. Okay, there's our bow. And then to make the little tie, you want to find a scrap probably that you cut off already while you're making it, or search around. You'll have scraps. Trust me, you will have scraps if you've been wrapping presents. Sometimes I like to save those strips too for when I miscalculate my wrapping paper and I have that gap. You ever do that? And you're like on the back of your present, you've got like an inch gap all the way because you cut your paper too short trying to save a buck. And yeah, is that just me? I don't know. So then what I'm going to do is trim that down a little bit because it's a little too long. And just wrap that little scrap around. Look at that nice puffy bow. I love that. You don't need a die cut for that, people. You don't need a punch board or a die cut to do that. And then I'm all wound up today. And then we're gonna just put a piece of tape across. And voila, we have a lovely bow. And we could stick that right on our present or on our head if we want to have a fancy hair bow. I don't know. Do whatever you want to do. I'm not gonna judge. And, you know, just tape it down with a piece of tape and Bob's your uncle. I want to thank you so much for watching. Have a happy, happy holiday and happy new year. And we'll see you next time. Till next time, happy crafting.